This is my intro. This is my intro. What's up, my rosebuds? It's Alexa, and welcome back to a brand new video. So, I don't know about you guys, but I am terrible at gifting gifts for guys, whether it be my dad, my brother, my boyfriend, my guy cousins. I am terrible at it. I literally just give them socks and maybe beer like every Christmas. So, if you guys are kind of struggling with gift ideas for guys, I'm gonna share with you guys some ideas that I feel like guys would like and appreciate. Maybe not, I'm not sure, I'm not a guy, but if I was a guy, I think I would like them. I am partnering with the Peach Box for this video. The Peach Box is a jewelry company based out in Australia, and they have a ton of really pretty jewelry pieces. Today I'm wearing the Mark Bale watch, and this one is in rose gold, and as you guys can see, it has a bunch of little rhinestones around the face. I'm also wearing the Roman numerals bangle and the nail wrap ring. I love this ring so much because it's an alternative to the Cartier nail ring. If you guys don't want to drop $2,000 on a ring, this is a great dupe. If you guys haven't finished your Christmas shopping yet, I think these would make great gifts because who doesn't like getting jewelry for Christmas? You guys can also use my 15% off code NAVAROSE for money off your order. I will put links down below for the Peach Box so you guys can go ahead and check them out. And also, so if you guys are a BTS fan, I have a special announcement kind of ish at the end of this video, so stay tuned to the very end to find out. Also, if you guys are new to this channel, welcome, and don't forget to subscribe down below and hit the notification bell so you don't miss out on the next time that I post. And without further ado, let's jump right into these tutorials. For these candles, you need some faux candles. I got these from the dollar store, actual tea light candles, but this is optional, a glue stick, scissors, and white contact paper. First, what you want to do is print out your logos on a regular sheet of paper and make sure your image is mirrored, and then you're going to roughly cut out around the logo. Add some glue to the back of the image and paste it onto the wrong side of the contact paper. You then want to cut around your logo once the glue has dried. Tape your logo onto the candle first so you can see if you're happy with the placement, and once you're satisfied, peel off the backing and place it onto the candle. I also wiped my candle with some rubbing alcohol to make sure the surface was clean. So I decided to do a Supreme candle because they had these red candles for Christmas, and for the black candle I used the Stussy logo because I love Stussy so much and I thought it would look cool on a black candle. These candles are battery powered, so you don't have to worry about them running out. However, if you want to add some actual candles inside to make it look a little bit more real and to add some scent, all you have to do is split a cotton ball in half, place it at the very bottom of the candle, and put a tea light candle on top. Obviously, it's not that appealing from an aerial view, but if it's sitting up high, like elevated on a shelf or something, then it actually looks like a real candle. For the vase, you'll need a square vase. I got this one at the dollar store, a glue stick, black paint, a paintbrush, scissors, and white contact paper. The first step is to paint the entire inside of the vase with black paint. I did one layer first and then added a second layer after it was dried. To add the logo, you're basically going to do the same exact steps as the previous tutorial, so all you're going to do is cut out the logo in your contact paper and place it onto your vase. Definitely, definitely, definitely make sure the paint inside of the vase is dried or else you'll end up like me. Lastly, put in your plant. I would actually prefer using a fake plant if you're giving this to a guy because not all guys have green thumbs. However, if you do use a real one, I suggest leaving it in its pot so you can water it from time to time without ruining the inside of the vase. For the flask, you'll need a roll of black self-adhesive vinyl, a stainless steel flask, an X-Acto knife,
a glue stick, scissors, and tape. You're basically gonna do the same tutorial again. This time I'm using big old English letters to make it personalized for the person that I'm giving this to. I actually messed up here because I was supposed to mirror the image, but I forgot to, so instead I had to glue the image face down, but luckily the ink was pretty bold so I was still able to see it from behind. I also used vinyl instead of contact paper since it is a little thicker and I figured it would be handled more often than a vase and some candles, but honestly it's up to you. If you're using old English font like I am, you'll definitely need an X-Acto knife to cut out those small spaces. For the placement, I taped the letter down first and then I used strips of tape to make a border. This definitely helped me to center my vinyl better. And that's pretty much it. I think it's a great gift for any guy, but you know, just make sure they're over 21. And hopefully none of my guy cousins are watching this right now or else they'll know what they got for Christmas. For the supreme pillow, you'll need pillow fluff, half a yard of red cotton fabric, transfer paper for darks, paper shears, fabric shears, and an iron, which I didn't film. First, what you want to do is cut a rectangle out of your material so that it's 21 inches by 10 inches folded. Then sew a straight stitch around the pillow, leaving a 4-inch gap on the side. Once that's sewn, turn your pillow inside out. Personally, I like to cut the corners of the tip so that the pillow corners are nice and sharp when I invert it. So I had to darken this clip like crazy just so you guys can see, but there is actually a faint border around the Supreme letters. It's just really hard to see, but trust me, it's there. You're gonna print the letters onto the fabric paper and then cut them out. Make sure you're using the fabric paper for darks or else it will bleed onto your fabric. Place your letters onto the pillow, peel off the backing, and iron it on. Let your pillow cool down first and then stuff it with the pillow fluff. Once you're happy with the firmness, fold in the edges of the opening and sew a straight stitch to close it up to finish it. You can use any logo you want, honestly, for any of these tutorials. I just picked streetwear since it's more relatable to me. I definitely think the candles and the vases would be a great gift because I know when it comes to decor, some guys aren't really into it because it seems more of a girl thing. So hopefully these would be something that they're into. It looks nice and it's also kind of manly-ish. These are great for any low maintenance guys, especially if you don't use the tea light candles and a real plant. All the tutorials I have for you for today. If you guys like this video and want to see me make more guy stuff, then give this video a big thumbs up to let me know that. You guys can't even see my thumbs up because of this fur. If you guys want to connect with me on social media, all my socials are at The Novel Rose. Also, you guys, I'm still doing the Christmas gift giveaway. If you guys don't know what that is, I'm picking one lucky winner and they could pick anything from the DIY featured video. And the way to enter into this giveaway is to comment down below your favorite celebrity crush, guy or girl that you would like to receive as a Christmas gift. And the winners for the previous DIY gifts giveaway is Femi Adegoke and Jadis Kane. Oh my gosh, I'm butchering these names. I am so, so sorry. So if you guys are the winners, check down below to see how you could claim your prizes. And yes, I did pick two winners. So I'm most likely going to pick two winners for this video as well. So definitely get your entries in and I will announce the winners in my next video. Okay, so my BTS fans, I have been so obsessed with BTS ever since you guys have brought them to my attention. Literally the amount of hours, no, scratch that, days that I have been binge watching and binge listening to them is probably unhealthy and I don't really care. I'm going to be doing a BTS DIY video and a styling lookbook as well. I'm probably gonna just merge the two. So if any of you BTS fans out there wanna see me recreate like accessories or clothes or anything DIY-ish, DM me on Instagram, make sure it's Instagram so that you guys could send me photos and etc., etc. And I will pick my three favorite DIYs and put those into the video. I'm literally going to get working on it after Christmas. I am so excited. Yeah, that's pretty much it. I love you guys all so much and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.